Assalamu alaikum. In our previous video, we learned how to create geometry. In this video, we will learn how to create structural mesh when air flows through a square cylinder. After updating geometry, we have to open mesh modeler. After that, the very first step we have to do is to update mesh. Select face selection tool and select all the faces present in the geometry. Apply face meshing. Face meshing will change all the elements into quads. Select all four edges of square cylinder with the help of edge selection tool and apply sizing. Now change the definition type into number of divisions and divide the four edges of square cylinder into 80 number of divisions. Change the behavior type into hard. Similarly, select the outer edges of square cylinder and apply sizing and divide the edges into 120 number of divisions and change the behavior hard again. Now select the outer edges of the square cylinder and make the number of divisions 80 similar to the square cylinder. Similarly, we have to divide all other edges into number of divisions according to our requirements. We only need dense mesh near the square cylinder. Dividing the edges into the number of divisions mean that you divide each individual edge into given number of divisions or elements. Edges which are away from the square cylinder, we divide these edges into less or small number of divisions such as 20 because we don't need dense mesh there. The horizontal edges on the back side of the square cylinder, we divide these edges into 100 number of divisions because these edges are very large as compared to other edges. Now just update the mesh. The element size in this mesh is not same. Some elements are large, some are very small. So we have to apply baising. If we don't apply baising, it will give floating error. And we can't solve the problem. The element size should be in such way that it must be small at the edges of square cylinder and gradually increase when we move outward or away from the square cylinder. For that we have to apply biasing. The upper and the lower element of these edges should be same of in size. Now we will apply biasing. Make sure while applying biasing, the direction of biasing of all the edges should be same. You can check the direction of three biasing is same, but one is in reverse direction. So we select edge selection tool and apply reverse biasing on the fourth edge. Most important step while applying biasing, we have to change the element on the corner of the square cylinder into square. For that, we have to apply biasing in such way that the corner elements of the square cylinder change into square. Orthogonality is not important, only the element should be in square. You can check these are almost in square, but we have to still improve. You will learn these things gradually. Actually, we have to make the length and the width of the square element same. So it is almost square now. You can check. Now apply biasing on other edges similarly and follow these steps. The direction of all the biasing should be same and it should be towards the scale cylinder. Similarly, we apply biasing on all other edges. You have to follow these steps, just follow these steps. This is the most important step. You have to make the center element of the edge upper and lower side should be same for all the four edges. We have to apply biasing toward the scale cylinder. So those edges which are not toward the scale cylinder, we have to change their direction. Our goal was to make the element size up and down side of the edge same like this on all the four edges. To do so, we have to apply biasing on the remaining edges of the geometry. So follow all the steps. After applying biasing on the edges back side of the scale, we will create name selection. Now you can check the center element of these all four edges are almost same in size. Check this. Now select the intake edges and create name selection as inlet and outlet edges as outlet, and select the domain name as a domain wall and scale cylinder edges as a scale cylinder. So here structure mesh is almost complete. After doing all these things, you have just to update. Thank you. In our next video, we will discuss how to apply setup conditions for this case. Thank you for watching the video.